when we're doing pattern matching over strings in SQL, we often go to the like operator first. But there's another operator called similar to, which is even more powerful, that allows us to use regular expressions. Let's look at an example working with the job titles here. And I'm going to select all the distinct job titles. And I'm going to select that from the data size schema and the employees table within that schema. And what we'll notice here is we have a few different kinds of VPs, like VP of sale, VP of quality control. We also have a number of different web, like web developer, and there's some other web designers in here, web designer 3. So we have some patterns around VP and around web that I think would be good candidates to work with. So let's start with something simple. Let's select all the VPs. Well, we could use the like operator here. We can say where job title like VP followed by any number of characters. And if I execute that, I'm going to see that we have 5 types of VPs. Now, if I also wanted to include in this list anybody involved with web, like a web developer or web designer, I could use an OR clause and specify additional conditions like job title like web percent. And now I'm going to get a list of VPs and web developers and web designers. Well, as you can imagine, if you have a list, a fairly long list of different patterns you want to match, using OR clauses could get a little cumbersome. A more succinct way of expressing the same condition is to instead use the similar to clause instead of the like clause. And the way we can do that is we can specify we want to match on a VP followed by any number of characters, or on web followed by any number of characters. And to specify the OR operator, I use a single pipe. So that's the single pipe, and spaces are matched. So I'm going to make sure that this is the correct string. And because this is a list, I'm going to wrap it in parentheses. So what this is saying is exactly what the last command said, which is to select the distinct job titles from employee where the job title matches on VP followed by any number of characters or web followed by any number of characters. So if we execute, we get the same list, which is what we'd expect. Now, a moment ago, I intentionally removed the spaces that I had put in there. Now, typically, I like to use a lot of white space because it helps me read code a little more easily. However, this white space is within a string. There's those two quotes. So that means it's going to become part of the pattern that will be matched. So this pattern, the first one would be VP, followed by any number of characters, and then the last character of the string is a space. In the case of the web pattern, the pattern that would be matched here is a space followed by WEB followed by a number of characters. So let's run that. Okay, we don't get any results. And again, that's because the non-printing characters have become part of the pattern that we're matching. So we want to be careful with how we use non-printing characters, especially around things like spaces and tabs. So if we run this again, we'll get what we expect. Okay, now let's look at just VPs. So here, I'm just going to work with VPs for a moment. And I'm going to intentionally make some mistakes here because that, again, that kind of helps us understand how regular expressions work. So I would expect to get all 5 VP types. And we did. Now, let's say I'm interested in only VPs of accounting, administration, and any other departments or divisions that begin with the letter A. So what if I have VP and I want to say, I'm just going to match VP followed by any number of characters, and then I want to match on an A. Well, that didn't work. But I'm trying to think what went on there. Well, again, this whole thing, this whole entire pattern has to match. So unlike regular expressions in some programming languages where this could match on a substring and be true, in SQL, the pattern has to match the entire string. So what I am not saying is what happens after the letter A, and what I want is really anything could follow after the letter A. So here I'm saying string starts with VP, followed by a percent, followed by an A, followed by a percent. And the percent, remember, matches on any number of characters. So that's basically giving me anything that starts with VP and also has an A in it anywhere. And actually all five names of VPs have an A in it. Well, really what I want is to match VP followed by a single space followed by an A. I could put in VP space A and execute that, and that will match. Now, I could also say VP followed by any character, and I can specify that by using the underscore, and this will also match on VP accounting. And let's do a quick check at those five. And let's say if I wanted something that started with an A or an M, I could have VP, and I want to follow by a space, and I want to match on either an A or an M. Now, if I ran this, I'm not going to get any results, because again, I forgot to put the percent sign at the end, which says match on any number of characters following the A or following the M. And here what we see is we're getting what we expect now, which is the VP of accounting and VP of marketing. So there are other things that you can use within regular expressions, other pattern indication specifications. So for things like matching a particular character a certain number of times or matching on digits, I'd look at the Postgres documentation to see how you can build even more complex regular expressions. And my one piece of advice with regular expressions is to build them incrementally. So start with something really simple and start building. And when things all of a sudden aren't behaving the way you expect, you can isolate pretty quickly what change you made that is changing the behavior that you don't quite understand.